It is 7 minutes after 12, and how fitting that we should start the hour with brass, because in this hour we have a 107 Live. We're going to be hearing the story of 17-year-old Connor Augusto, who has been given a scholarship to Juilliard. That's coming up right now.
And now from our studios in downtown Winnipeg, it's time for 107 Live.
Now that's a way for an intro. Can I just bring you guys with me everywhere I go?
We are available.
That was the sound of Connor Augusto, 17-year-old from Winnipeg, who has been given a scholarship to go to Juilliard. And his teacher, the associate a principal horn player of the WSO and instructor at U of M, both of them join me in the studio to talk about what it means to get a scholarship from Juilliard for a student in Winnipeg and what goes with it. Let's just start off by talking with Connor. Welcome to Classic 107.
Thank you.
Congratulations, first of all. What an exciting thing to happen for you. Tell me how you found out. Tell me about the moment.
Well, they sent me an email that said, an update has been added to your application status. And I kind of thought that meant, I guess I didn't get in. But then you click on it and you go to their website and it pops up this page with confetti and congratulations, you've been accepted to Juilliard. It was just such a amazing, overwhelming moment. It was so happy.
So tell me about how long have you been playing the French horn? How did that all start?
I started on trumpet in fifth grade because my grandpa was a jazz band musician and he got me started a bit early. And in sixth grade, I switched to playing the French horn because I wanted a bit more of a challenge. And I heard that the French horn is the harder instrument. So I've been playing it about 7 years.
And did you find that? And how did you come to fall in love with the instrument?
Yeah, it was really hard at first, but I stuck with it. And I really grew to love the sound and how the instrument can play. And eventually, I got some good teachers and got to where I am. And it's been a really great journey.
So that's my next question. It's one thing to play in concert band at school, but it's quite another to decide to pursue this on a higher level and take lessons outside of school. How did that come about?
Well, one of the horn players at the high school when I was in middle school was pretty talented, and my middle school band teacher sent me to him because she thought I could do well. And I started getting lessons with him, and he deferred me to another teacher, and I went through a few teachers before I got to Ken.
So let's do a few shout-outs to those teachers and instructors who have helped you along the way.
I started with Naboisha Oravec, who was the high school student. He sent me to Shannon Moses because he got another job. Shannon Moses sent me to Zach Dark because she was going on maternity leave, and Zach Dark was Ken's student. And eventually he said to Ken, I think this guy is advancing too quickly. Can you teach him instead? And that's how I got to Ken.
So Ken, let's bring you on in. Ken McDonald, everybody. Welcome to Classic 107.
Thank you.
So tell me about the first time you met Connor.
Well, it was through Zach, as Connor said, and exactly that. In grade 9, Zach said, I just can't teach this kid anymore. So since then, Connor has been basically studying with me at a university level. So although I teach at the U of M and I would dearly love to see him there as a student, it's time to kick him down the road a little bit. And so that's why we're having a kind of a gala celebration concert to celebrate him moving on, hopefully to Juilliard. It's ridiculously expensive to go there, but we've got to see what we can do to make it work and make it happen and get him the education. And just for context, asking around, we don't think a brass player from Manitoba has ever gone straight to Juilliard from high school. The last person to go to Juilliard, I think, from Manitoba was James Ennis.
Just James Ennis.
I think so. I don't quote me on that. Well, I guess you have to quote me on it. It's on the radio.
It's on the radio. It's out there now. So at what point, Ken, did you realize as a teacher that, we need to apply to these kinds of schools?
Well, I had it in the back of my mind right away, actually, like, okay. But getting to those schools, like I've sent students on to McGill and University of Toronto before. Those are very fine schools, as well as U of M. But those schools, like they gave them a scholarship right away and said, okay. But I thought, you know, let's go for the gold. So we got to the Glenn Gould School of the Royal Conservatory. They had one opening this year for horn. And
which Connor also got.
Which Connor has also received an invitation
wow.
to that. And so they and Juilliard are somewhat competing for him, because there were four openings at Juilliard this year with Eric Ralski's studio. And so he's got one of the four openings. And that's a worldwide competition to get into that studio.
That's incredible, Connor. That is so wonderful. That is just awesome. We've just met, but I'm so proud of you.
Yeah. Thanks so much.
So tell us, so what does it mean then, like financially? What are we talking about?
Well, Juilliard, after they've given me a $35,000 scholarship, which covers most of tuition, but it leaves out about $10,000 US of tuition and the costs of living in downtown Manhattan, which are really high. So my goal, I think it would cost about $40,000 a year to study at Juilliard, which is pretty expensive.
Yeah, ouch. So what's happening in terms of raising money?
I've set up an online fundraiser, and I'm putting on this concert on Sunday.
And so tell us about the concert.
It's with me and Mitchko Singh and Ken here. Mitchko's the fourth horn of the Winnipeg Symphony Orchestra, and it's in Oakbank at the Oakbank United Church.
So that's Sunday afternoon. That's at 582 Balsam Crescent in Oakbank, which is where you live, right, Connor?
Yeah.
And you go to high school there?
Yeah, at the Springfield Collegiate.
And what can people expect at the concert? What kinds of things will you be performing?
A few concertos, a horn trio, and a few horn solo pieces.
Now, I also understand that even though you haven't graduated from high school yet, that's coming up in a few months, but you guys sort of need to let them know very soon.
Yeah. The deadline for Glenn Gould is Monday. So
oh boy.
I have to make my choice between Glenn Gould and Juilliard by then.
Wow. That's a little bit of pressure.
Yeah.
So basically what you'll do is it'll depend on how much money has been raised online and with this concert on Sunday
yeah.
is how you'll make the decision as
and
to what
I
you'll do.
And if I figure I could raise enough in the next few months if I choose to go to Juilliard. So it'll be kind of a putting a guess of how much it'd be possible versus the safe option of Glenn Gould.
So Ken, not to put you on the spot, well, why should people give money?
Well, this is a Canadian talent that we're investing in here. He doesn't qualify for the same loans, the Canada student loans. And a friend of mine asked me point blank, why not just stay in Canada and get the loans? And going to the United States is a big jump. But when you look at other Canadian talent that has done so and the rich rewards that come back to our community for that, like if you follow the rarefied world of French horn, Connor is somebody, you're going to hear his name in the future. And I think this is an investment that we're making in talent in our community, and we're saying this is what we value. So I do encourage people to take a look at his GoFundMe/ConnorGoesToJuilliard, and then also to come to the concert and just look online at what he's doing. I think I'm just very excited to have a student that is going gangbusters like this.
You must be so proud. Connor, one more question. I know you guys have a little something to play for us in this 107 Live. Is your grandfather still with you?
Yes.
What does he think of all of this?
Oh, he's super proud, of course.
I can only imagine. I can only imagine. All right, so what are you guys going to play for us?
Oh, we have a little duet for you here. It's by a fellow named Carl. I don't know his first name. We'll just call him Carl.
All right. Off you go. Thank you. Beautiful. Thank you so much. 17-year-old Connor Augusto and his teacher, WSO Associate Principal Horn Player and Instructor at U of N, Ken McDonald. The concert happens this Sunday afternoon at 2 p.m. in Oakbank at the United Church there, 582 Balsam Crescent in Oakbank. And you can also go online and donate money that way. All the information is at classic107.com. Just go to our website and you'll find everything that you need to know. You know what? Whether you decide to go to Juilliard or to Glenn Gould, Connor, they will be lucky to have you.
Thank you so much.
From our studios in downtown Winnipeg, you've been listening to 107 Live, Classic 107's Intimate Concert Series, the soundtrack for your life.